Barbers and hairdressers working at Kings and Queens Beauty and Hair Salon in Windhoek have been left stranded after their abrupt eviction on Monday. The salon was home to 46 breadwinners who claim to have only received notice to vacate the building within 6 hours of the same day.
We're actually experiencing difficulties today when the owner of the salon, the person that actually owned the contract of the salon, came in today to tell us that we should actually leave the premises today, which I find quite unreasonable and also quite not mature enough of it to do, because it would have been appropriate if she had come to us a month ago and tell us, please give us a month notice to tell us that we should leave the place. So she comes to us today. We have clients who have to tell that, no, I'll be moving and so forth. But right now she's just coming today and telling us that we need to leave today. 4 hours, like 4 or 5 hours before the business closes for the day. We find it actually quite unfair. And from time to time, I've been asking her if she could not give us contracts that we can sign with them and so on. And they always refused us that. They never wanted to give us that. So even if we don't have a contract with them on paper, we still pay them money. I mean, I have my proof with the bank where I actually send money to one of the partners of the business. Right? So it would have been appropriate for them to just give us a month notice, even though we don't have a written contract with them. It's just the best thing to do. And now they are telling us that the owner of the building gave them short notice by only sending them an email yesterday, which I found, I don't actually believe that. I don't think so. Because who will actually tell the tenant that, no, leave today? Why not give them a month notice or so? Because if I remember last year, was it this year, that she came to us and she told us that, no, the owner of the building don't want us to move out of here because they already lost enough tenants in the building due to coronavirus. And right now, she came and tell us that the owner told us that they should move. So which owner told her not to move and which owner told her to move? So she's actually mixing up things here, and we don't understand it. You know, it would have been fair if they given us a good explanation as to her telling us that they don't owe anything on the building, but they own municipality, and the owner of the building went to municipality to go and inquire about what money they owe municipality. And municipality now, I mean, and the owner of the building came and told them to move. It doesn't make sense. It does not make sense at all for the owner of the building to go to municipality to go ask about the tenant of them on how much they owe. That's nothing to do with the owner of the building, but the person that owned the contract of the salon in municipality. That's actually how I understand it. If there's maybe something else that I don't understand, then maybe somebody can clarify on me on that. But right now we are really in grief because we are losing our incomes here. We have families to feed, we have bills to pay. So now we have to start all over again with everything. And it's really saddening because we never thought this place would really close, and since it was considered one of the biggest and most successful salons in this place. I've been here since 2014. The owners I found here never gave us any threat or any impression that it's going to close anytime soon. And they come in, ever since they came in, it's always been things of, we can close it anytime we want to. We can close it anytime we want to. And today it actually happened. So I feel like this is something that they've been planning all along and not, as they say, the owner of the building. People are really actually quite depressed, saddened by this, because none of us expected this at all. Because we all pay our money. Yes, maybe there are those who didn't pay the money on time, but for us that pay, we really